Okay, now we've talked about the heart and we've touched on that and how blood flows around the body through the arteries, veins, and then the capillaries. We're going to touch on the circulatory system now and how the body uses that blood and where it needs to go to transport all of that blood and what's within it. So if we break the circulation down, or the circulatory system down, into two segments, we have the pulmonary circulation, which is the blood flow from the right side of the heart. So anything that comes out of the heart will have oxygen in it. It's going to have a lower pressure, because then it's going to have almost, if you think about going down a hill within your body, it's going to be able to go down your body to with gravity. So it doesn't need to have that build up of pressure. The second one is systemic circulation, is what we call where it comes back round your system. So systemic as a word. It comes back around your system and it has to climb your body. So climbing up the hill, it needs that added pressure. So what's going to happen? It's going to constrict your veins are going to constrict, allow that blood pressure to come back up the body all the way into your heart and then your lungs. So talking then just about pulmonary and systemic circulation, what we need to know and learn about is blood pressure. So a good indication for blood pressure is body weight. The more body weight that we hold, the higher our blood pressure usually is, because that means that the circulatory system has to push blood to that the rest of the whole of your body. So to be a healthy human being, it allows your heart to have less to do, because it's got to have less places to travel around and push blood to. When we take a blood pressure reading, usually with a monitor and a blood pressure monitor, you take two readings, a systolic pressure and a diastolic pressure. Now, systolic pressure is when the heart contracts, and then diastolic pressure is when the heart relaxes. So as we pump, involuntary, it contracts and then pushes blood out, contracts and pushes blood out. So there's two readings that we need to take. One changes and one doesn't change that much, depending on how much blood needs to be pushed around the body. What we'll find is the contraction will be pushing that blood as our heart rate goes up in a response to exercise or a stimulus, whether it's a reaction of fear or running. Okay, pushing through blood pressure, what we need to know for our clients is how we classify those different readings for systolic and diastolic blood pressure. Now, what we measure our blood pressure in is millimoles of hemoglobin, and that's broken down and shortened into mmHg. So if we look at our systolic blood pressure, it's usually the higher one, and as a normal range in a classification, it's about 120 millimoles of hemoglobin. Diastolic blood pressure is normal range is about 80. So if we think about and judge 75 to 80 millimoles of hemoglobin, we take that reading 120 over 80. What we tend to see as the classification gets worse with our health is the systolic blood pressure readings increase, as well as our diastolic blood pressure increase. So if we go through some readings, what could be classed as poor and what we classify them as in terms of the names. So the World Health Organization classify all the readings for blood pressure, what's categorized as good heart rate, and all those different health signs. And what they've done is they've broken it down into pre-hypertension, which is a reading of 120 to 139 in our systolic blood pressure, or 80 to 89 for our diastolic blood pressure. Now, as you can see, that's not a lot of difference between the normal range of 120 or less. So we just need to manage that, and it's not going to increase significantly with each day. Generally, your blood pressure doesn't change each day as much. It just might change as the health gets worse or gets better over a longer period of time, or you have a drastic health decline due to an illness or something like that. So if we go to our next stage, is stage one hypertension, and you'll get a reading of 140 to 159 over 90 to 99. So that can be severely dangerous, and we want to be going, we should have already been to the doctor or the GP to discuss this, as you will have visual signs from someone observing you, and you'll be able to feel that blood pressure being at a high rate. And then the last stage, which is categorized as the worst, is stage 2 hypertension. And this is when you'll probably be in hospital at this point if you're above this range, and you'll be able to see your health declining at an advanced rate. And you'll see readings of 160 over 100 or more.